mental illnesses are complex and often difficult to diagnose and treat. When two or more disorders come together, the complexity of the individual's needs and symptoms skyrocket. Whether you're studying to become a mental health practitioner or believe you are struggling with co-occurring disorders, you must do your research to understand how mental health illnesses can interact with each other. Keep watching as we discuss co-occurring disorders, their symptoms, and how to treat them. Co-occurring disorders. While many individuals may have one specific mental illness, those with co-occurring disorders simultaneously experience two or more mental health illnesses. This can involve multiple mental health illnesses, addictions, or eating disorders happening co-currently. For example, someone who suffers from alcoholism and depression has co-occurring disorders. These individual mental illnesses can interact both with each other and any addictions that may form to treat the disorder or disorders. Dangers. If drugs or alcohol are involved as a form of self-medication, then that individual should receive immediate treatment. Addiction can cause mental health disorders to spiral quickly out of control and risk other disorders developing. Severe mental illnesses such as psychosis and schizophrenia should also be brought to a mental health professional as soon as possible. They are concerning, and if the disorder worsens drastically, then that person may become a threat to themselves or others. Self-harm or suicide attempts should also be treated immediately. This shows that the individual wants to cause serious harm to themselves and requires treatment as soon as possible to prevent further harm. The same goes if the individual has attempted to harm someone else as well. Treating co-occurring disorders. Co-occurring disorders may seem difficult to manage, but treatment options are available to you or your loved one. Therapy or counseling is a great way to start expressing your feelings and concerns in a non-judgmental environment. A therapist can also help detect potential triggers and teach you ways to avoid these triggers in the future. While individual therapy is one option, group therapy is also beneficial for individuals with co-occurring disorders. Not only will they be given the benefits of individual counseling, but they can talk with others who share similar experiences to them. Inpatient counseling and treatment may prove necessary for those with mental illnesses that cause them to want to harm themselves or others. In a mental health facility, the individual can properly be cared for and treated without the worry of them harming someone. Finally, you may require medication for your mental illnesses to move towards a healthier future. This is nothing to be ashamed of. Speak with a medical doctor so that you can get the right medications. They will know how to treat your illnesses and how to select medications that won't interact negatively with each other. Are you considering a career as a mental health professional but aren't sure where to go? Do you know someone who has a helpful heart that may be interested in joining the field of addiction studies or an entry-level career in mental health? We may be a great option. Contact us with any questions or concerns you may have about joining the mental health or addiction studies field. And if you found this video helpful, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more content.